Following video is rated M for strong language and idiotic mistakes. May contain spoilers with attitude.
You have been warned.
Wait, didn't we use this? Didn't it tell me? Wait, what the? Okay, never mind. Never mind. Just go with it. It's okay. Just go with it. Wait, what's going on? What's going on? Oh! Crap, melted. Oh my god, I love this game. This game's like, you know what? We're gonna be an adventure game. And we're gonna be on a creepy space derelict ship with creepy things on there. We're gonna scare the shit out of you. But more importantly, we're gonna get really creative with all the ways to get you killed. I love that. That is amazing. So you get yourself, you melt yourself, you got options. And that's amazing. This is awesome. Oh my god, this is awesome. Okay. Oh, this is awesome. All right, buddy. Come on, John. Let's do this again, buddy. And honestly, the checkpoint system, like, the game, the creator's like, no. You're gonna do something pretty stupid. So they give you that, like, that option to not die. Well, to die, but to die in curiosity. So they give you that wiggle room. All right, get out of here, John. John. All right, so is it good now?
Oh God.
That looks important. Let's just yank that out of there. Just get at it.
I can hear you're taking strain. But keep your eyes on the end goal. Your family, they need you.
Do not tell me what my family needs. I do not know you. Do not do that. All right. Just kind of like expecting some of the pop bands to get the shit out of me. Okay, go for the switch. Alright, this should let me actually bust open those locks.
So once I get this tram working, where do I go?
Your best bet is to find medical access terminal. Medical wing is on that tram line, so it should be a quick ride.
Thank you, Tia. I'm sorry about your friend.
Just be safe.
I mean, I feel like I want to like her, but she's not explaining anything, and I get maybe why, because it's just inopportune moments. But then there's like a part of me that's like, we'll see. I mean, I'm taking a lot of time to try to figure this stuff out here. Obviously, there's something of... Like, she could be telling me this, but maybe... She's head up. Like, higher up in the food chain. Tram line breaker. Is there a... Oh. Okay. Oh. Maybe I gotta... Okay, that should fix it. I like this game. Nice.
Okay, the tram's powered.
I see it. Give me destination from the medical wing.
Which is... I'm assuming what I gotta... No? No? I'm not... Oh, okay. Just run, buddy. There's something here. Maybe more than one thing. Please run. Good man. Oh, hang on. I bet you anything, I gotta go back over here. Please let that just be the computer. That is the computer, okay. Alright, charging status, end of the line. Is there any way to decouple the charging status? Ah, okay, okay. You only have one fuse to begin with. All right.
All done. Destination set. Start the tram and be on your way.
Oh. I like those cinematics, those cutscenes. This looks awesome.
How long?
How long what?
How long ago was the evacuation? My family would have left with everyone else, with the people that made it out.
That's, well, I'm not sure exactly.
That blood looked pretty dry.
It's been a while. We've been stuck in this death trap for about 3 months now.
3 months?
There are four of us recently. You and I were the last. We were repairing it. Shuttles. Almost done.
Yuri
was out getting supplies when... Well?
Was he a... I mean, were you and he?
Yuri? No. We
would have
killed each other long ago if we didn't eat each other to survive. I miss him, though. We got things done. I was married once. But that was a long time ago.
What happened?
How many of your cockroaches do I have to kill with it?
Lemon! Let's talk about this!
This was the last straw. I'm coming for you next. And as for your little egg...
Warning. Brakes disabled. Low-pass filters disabled. Structural integrity compromised. An evacuation is advised.
He's going to be around the track!
Okay, so I am wearing something. It's very tight. It's got like an 80s vibe. Cutscenes. And I love it. Oh god, I love it. So, we got a crazy person. Can't have a science fiction story, I guess, without a science fiction horror story without a crazy person. And we got a load screen? Is this legit? Really?
John? John? Are you okay? I lost the tram signal.
What the hell happened? Barely make you out.
Are you hurt?
Yes.
No. I think I'm okay.
Okay, never mind.
I'm fine. I need to get out of this tram. It's okay. I think I can make the jump.
Jump!
Okay, whoa. Maybe use the crowbar? Okay. No. I want you to use the crowbar as a... Oh, never mind. He got it. He got it. Oh! Shit! Don't tip.
Shit, that was close. I'm fine. You're waking up. I can't hear you. Hello? Tia? Come in. Radio's not working.
At least he has a little levity.
Get it together. First things first. Where the hell am I?
Well, let's grab the nylon tape.
I could use this.
I don't know for what. But we're gonna find out. Ooh, toolbox.
Oh, shit. Where the hell am I gonna find a key in this mess?
I don't need one. I have two options.
I can try to make it.
Oh, come on. Okay, how about a crowbar?
This ain't working.
Damn it. Like, you get a tool and it's like, yeah! And then it's like, you can't use it anymore, man. Kane certainly spared no expense out of the engineering decks. More often than not, the air conditioning breaks faster than maintenance can come back to fix it. The walk to the restrooms exceed 10 minutes on a good day. It isn't of no consequence. With the lush retirement package Kane has prepared for me, I'm happily working a cardboard box line with thumbsticks for the rest of my career. Ah, that's great. I'm scheduled to receive my new heart and lungs within the next few months, at which point I finally retire to join my wife, Rosalind, in Chicago. Until then, cigarettes and foods of the highest saturated fat content will continue to carry me through the day. This evening, I was surveying the equipment on the decks when I noticed something rather unusual, a very fine layer of some sort of fungal substance beginning to settle on the machinery. It's found its way into the dials and monitors. They look filthy on the inside. Given the conditions around here, though, the growth of mold on any surface should come as no surprise. But it seems to be interfering directly with the performance of the Groom Lake, so it's some urgency that it takes taken care of. Reported to maintenance, hopefully they'll be quickly cleaned up. K Corporation must be pleased with my performance so far. I woke up to a promotion. I'm in charge of the construction of new cloning vats, effective immediately. Time to elaborate. This job is important. Never anticipated the project would be on such a huge scale. Clones would be created in mass quantities, utilizing several megavats, fit it with special equipment and enrichment liquid to accelerate the growth process. Son of a bitch, I'm a clone. Oh god. How long has the original me died? Is there an original me now? Are they dead? Is it falsified? Like fake memories? Since the rate at which we'll be creating clone batches. They've invented a method of manufacturing human beings faster than humans combined biologically. Wait a minute, oh my god, that explains why I can die that way. Holy shit. What would be... Ooh, but that might have, like, tipped the hat a little bit if, like, they kept the bodies where they were. But, like, had them liquefy. Project Seed insists that the cloning vats are put to use immediately, despite the fact that they're far from complete. The vats can certainly sustain the cloning process, but some safety precautions are lacking, like the holding chambers for research clones have no power routed to them. So the electronic locks are useless. The walkways above the vats are still only temporary. Sullivan fell through over the guardrail and into a vat yesterday. Had it not been filled with sanitizing solution, we would have lost him. Clones appear to be operating entirely on instinct. One of the complete human clones in Vat Theta bit a good chunk out of Miss Keen's ear during feeding time. Ugh. Three of the completed research clones tore through their holding chambers on analog locks last night over in the labs. They found Peters bent over backwards with his head between his knees. He's not going to be walking anytime soon. Maintenance will be fixing the electronic locks this evening. Someone has asked to be assigned to a different project. I can kind of see why. Someone's request was denied. Keen, however, has transferred to Project Seed. I've been stealthily increasing the portions of food to Elon's batch in Vat 449. Although they're just hearts and lungs, I can't help but feel an attachment. Additionally, we've noticed a mass of organic matter that has sprouted a tail and swims around aimlessly.
Osobin wants to name it after his mother-in-law, who in their right mind names a defective clone. Samantha, the impossible human fish monstrosity, crushed Elon with her thrashing as she was being removed from her vat. Most of the clones in the batch have similar deformities. None of them actually grew into heart and lung tissue as they were meant to. In fact, the results thus far are truly horrifying. Everyone has been acting strangely lately. Sullivan didn't show up this week, leaving me to tend to the vats by myself. I don't understand why that's being permitted, but management would have most certainly dragged him down here by the cheeks if there's no legitimate justification. Speaking of cheeks, one of the complete human clones took a chunk out of mine when I was escorting it to the research labs. Jesus. The Groom Lake has been completely locked down. A massive tremor shook and collapsed the walkways over the cloning vats. I'm trapped. Can't access the bulkhead. If this lockdown is anything like it, I heard the last one was. It should be over soon enough. Hopefully sooner than rather than later. Tibet 6 will only last for so long. I can hear screams of terror through the ceiling. They echo. Each reverberation is a reminder that I'm damn fortunate to be down here and not up there. Although my supplies are running out, I sincerely hope that I don't have to swim for it. If the clones don't get me, cardiac arrest from the aerobic exercise will. I'm going to attempt to swim across Vat Theta. I'll reach to the side and try to get myself to the next level of the ship. Clones have been violently floundering in the growth liquid. Given what they did to Peters, I might not see the other side of this vat. The remainder of this entry is to be delivered to my wife. Rosalind, I can only hope that I have the opportunity to deliver this to you myself. If not, I must attempt to express with words what I have longed to convey physically. Should I die before I can get off this vessel, every moment of my life, every cumulative experience that has influenced my being, will scream your name, begging the reality of inevitable death to spare me, if only to touch you once more. Oh, shit. I apologize for and regret every second I've spent away from you until that moment we first met. My heart was full. Like the fierce fires, the passion that you bestowed within me, no matter the echo of my escape, I will be long dead before they are extinguished. For an eternity after I have perished, you will live on. Your name will ring out through the galaxy, a testament to all existence that exists. Aww. Too bad he died. Let's be honest.
2151. We left in 2148, 3 years ago. These bastards had us here for 3 years.
Crap. A little surprised with the load times, though. A little surprised. Actually wasn't anticipating it at all.
Tia, I don't know if you can hear me. But I'm in some sort of... Oh, I'm not sure what to call it.
Wait, what was that? What's that? There's the dead body. Well, he didn't make it. No, he did. They dragged him back down. So on a scale of 1 to 10, how bad is this going to be if I try to do anything?
It still has fuel in it.
Whoa!
Something's moving in there. It's alive.
No! Get back! Oh, get back. Oh, you gotta be shitting me. I can't go across that. Are you kidding me?
Probably not a good idea. This should be useful.
Fishing? Oh my god. Probably should have dragged that closer, buddy.
Rest in peace.
If I ever get out of this, and I don't have to be a clone, I'll make sure to pass your message along. Okay, what is this? Jumper cables.
This goes on here. I thought that was too easy.
Can I try that again? Maybe I can drill it by loosening up the screws on the bottom? If it has screws? Oh, it does! Now we can push it. Okay, I like this game. Let's try that again, buddy. With gusto, come on. Okay, well, you don't have gusto, but that's okay.
I don't know what I was thinking, man. Okay, now let's see what I can do.
I know what I'm thinking with this.
And this goes over here.
And they get a nasty jolt. Oh my god. Yep. Just don't get attacked. Please don't get attacked. John? Cool. Shit.
Can you hear me? I'm working on getting out of here. I can see a light far above me. I think it's a way out.
Oh my god, this game! So this began to move about the bat immediately during the embryonic phase. All subjects developing at nearly 500% acceleration. Effective growth agent concentration on subject development ruled parabolic rather than linear. Multiple subjects have combined to form a larger mass of arthropod limbs and organs. It surfaced and was then ruled deceased. It appeared to be composed of approximately 12 human-like bodies, all roughly infant-sized. The batch has been active for 96 hours. I wonder if the subject remains. Yeah, that's great. Oh, that's fantastic. Products developing at 100% acceleration from the sealed group control group. However, several anomalies have occurred. An example, tissue mass has developed into a tail of sorts. It circles the vat using the affirmation tail to propel itself. Mass with tail appendage has been assigned a name, Samantha. Despite the previous belief that the circling behavior has a product of instinct, it's now clear that it has been surveying the vat's electronic safety net and searching for vulnerabilities. Oh my god, okay. Samantha has been extracted and moved to security for temporary storage. She thrashed violently upon removal of damaged equipment and other specimens, as well as killing somebody. We'll leave that out, though. Because, you know, looks bad on the company. Subjects appear to develop bone and tendon structure prior to vital organs, but following nervous system development, growth of muscle has begun to progress. One specimen ceased to grow. It was confirmed dead. Upon autopsy, 3 extra vertebrae were discovered, as well as 2 ribs. However, only a few teeth were found deep within the mandible. Growth of all specimens have accelerated. Any given clone measures just under 12, under 7 feet. possesses the auxiliary ribs and vertebrae observed into the failed subject. All vital organs are present and appear to be performing normally. Despite the abnormal rib and spinal development, the clones seem to be perfectly functional and fully matured. One, however, was rendered blind as a result of improper sphenoid development. Oh, goody goody gumdrops. Jesus. So, okay. What is he? Are you trying to jump to reach it? Is that what you're doing? Because I feel like it'd be easier just to do this, buddy. There you go. And climb that son of a bitch. Or not. Well, there goes my toy.
I hate this damn place.
Yeah, you and I both, buddy. Jeez. How many vats are there? If you think about this, there's a good chance he's a clone of somebody who's actually either is or was alive.
John, can you hear me?
Tia,
okay. Trapdoor. What's with all the graffiti? Why graffiti?
Probably not a good idea.
I mean, doesn't that seem strange?
There's some sort of interference with the structure.
I'm in a tram station.
This is a science facility. Well, a research facility. Why is there graffiti? I mean, that just seems so strange. It's the damn kids. That's what it is, isn't it? This is damn kids. Okay.
The tower. I am pressurizing the raw materials containment tank.
Come in.
John, thank goodness. I can hear you. He just disappeared. No radio, no PDT.
Who the hell was that?
Dr. Aravis Milan, head of special projects.
He knew you.
It's a big ship. I'm in a different division to him entirely. And you met him once. A real arsehole.
I just want to get my family out of this goddamn place.
That's the plan.
Yeah, I kind of got the asshole part, by the way.
You lost my PDT.
Personal data tag. Every person on board has one.
Like animals.
The tags monitor everything. Security access, food intake, location tracking.
Everyone has a tag. We can use it to find my family.
I'm afraid it doesn't work like that, John.
Like hell it doesn't. If I'm tagged, then so are they.
I can only access your tag because the DotMake scanner has registered you. I've scanned for your family, and I can't pick them up.
Are they on the ship? Have they been rescued?
It only means their PDTs haven't been activated. But I still have an idea that might just work.
She's lying. Okay, so even if you are a real person, as in you were born naturally, you have your family, you might have been in cryosleep the whole time for 3 years, cryosleep, cryostate, whatever, they maybe took your family, experimented on them, threw them in one of those vats? I feel like there's no happy ending. Either you're a clone.
In the crew quarters, you should be close to an infirmary with a DNA sequencer. If you could get your blood into the sequencer, I could scan the ship for familial DNA. And then we can find your daughter. Then...
we can use her DNA to find Ellen.
Exactly.
Okay.
Notice. Reserve power facilities are online. Backup systems are now enabled and functioning at benchmark levels. The outside
temperature. But okay, so here, if you're a clone, it's a chance that your family's already been dead. They've been dead for much longer than 3 years. And they're no longer your family. Two, she has been, this Tia has been activating you, which there's many of you as clones, when one fails. Or three, you are actually really John. None of it's just good. None. The music's really, really amazing. Damn, it's good music. Hey guys, make sure you check out the videos below for more happy fun times. And if you already haven't, hit that subscriber button to let you know when more happy moments are coming to you on my channel. And finally, if you haven't, hit the like button. Gets you chocolate. No, I'm actually lying. Which I could give you chocolate.